It seems that a while back, as people followed you, you were really into peace at any, not at any cost, but just very peaceful. Peaceful means for the revolution. And I read an article in Ramparts, and you were into violent revolution. And now...
I'm not.
Well, that's what it, what it stated.
No, the article in Ramparts was basically about socialism, right? And I don't believe in violent revolution. Yoko stated it very well, which is violent revolutionaries are playing the same establishment game. I believe in some of the things Jerry Rubin and A.B. Hoffman have done, like the theater in court kind of revolution. I believe in the revolution of happening and that artists... Yoko says artists don't create. Any woman can create. A man can destroy with a Coke bottle. And an artist revalues. If I'm a revolutionary, or we are revolutionaries, we're revolutionary artists, not gunmen. I believe in the Black Panther original statement, the 10-point program, which is not violent, which says to defend yourself against attack, I might consider that. Mm. But anything else, I don't consider. So I'm still for peace, peaceful revolutionary. But I'm an artist first and a politician second.
I don't know if the article was wrong or not, but it stated you were saying in your song Revolution.
What?
That in your song Revolution.
Yeah.
You wanted to change a few of the words from count me in to count me out, or count me out
no,
to count
it,
me in.
I have both versions. Revolution, there's three versions. Number one,
but
number two, and number nine. Number nine is an abstract picture of revolution. Number one was the single because the other boys didn't like number... No, the number two is the single because the other boys didn't like number one. They said it wasn't fast enough, so I made it fast. And sometimes I said count me in, count me out. The thing I regret... was making a reference to Chairman Mao, which might spoil any chances I have of going to visit China, like those ping-pong people do. I'd love to go and see what's happening there. But I wrote the Chairman Mao line in the studio because I didn't have any words. What I was trying to say to the Maoists, or anybody that wanted to change the world, why go and stand in front of a policeman with a red communist flag in your hand and a big suit and all like that, and then get hit? I thought it was unsubtle. So in the song, I wasn't putting down revolution. I was saying, isn't that a bit unsubtle? But if you want to really change the thing, do it subtly in a way that the establishment can't attack, i.e. theatre in court and or bed events, two virgins, things like that. Things that the establishment don't understand, therefore they can't kill it.
Right,
I'd like to know about some things about you. Things like when we first met, you brought me that album of Sioux music, Sioux Indian music. I'd like to know how interested you are in Indians, and are you interested in, quotes, the Red Revolution and power for the Red Indian, you know, that kind of thing. Are you interested, you know, what are American people doing for Indians? That's a big question over in Europe.
Yeah, I'm getting more and more interested in that. First, I was just interested in Indians like a kid at the cowboy movies. That's how it started. And then I come from the Midwest where there are, there are Indians everywhere.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I used to see some as a kid. Yeah. And then, I don't know, I guess you just develop a feeling that's so tragic, that whole period of me lie-like incidents, the Sand Creek Massacre, the Custer's wiping out of the Indians at
I just heard something very interesting on the what are those Indians down, the Incas and those other ones that could write.
Aztecs and...
The Mayans.
Oh, the Mayans, yeah.
I was reading, somebody on TV was talking about how one of when the Spanish came, these priests burned for 30 days all the Mayan books, so there was none left, and his reason was... it's either the word of God, and we've already got that, so we'll destroy it, and if it isn't, it's the work of the devil. So they destroyed the whole Mayan culture, literature, which was very good and very aware, and there was about three books left which sort of say, you know, got up and went to work, and there's not enough words for them to work out what the language was.
That's right,
and
this one man destroyed a whole written
one up for Christianity.
Culture. Yeah.
Yeah.
Also, the man who led the Indians against, who led the cavalry against the Indians at the Sand Creek Massacre was... a man of the cloth.
Oh, yeah.
Not that all
you had
men
a good,
of the cloth.
You had an interesting Indian on your show you were telling me about, too.
I have. I had a man who was also a great authority on Indians. I'd love
he was at Custer's Last Stand or something.
No, he was a friend of Curly, who was Custer's scout, John Neihart.
Oh. You didn't know he was an Indian freak, did you? So
but
what about
thing
the
is
Red
that you
Revolution,
feel like
then?
You maybe
know,
you
I mean,
could...
What's going
to
happen?
You feel so frustrated at what was done to the Indians in the past that you feel like you should do something for their descendants now, who are still getting it
well,
six
I know,
ways.
Illiterate and not educated, not looked after.
Yeah.
I mean, they're like, I don't know if they're having it worse than black people here, but it's pretty rough for them, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very bad, and I think it's good that people have a sense of conscience about it and are doing something about it.
Well, they've made so much money out of the Indians. At first they took the land, and then they made movies about them taking the land, you know?
Yeah.
It's a bit mean, you know? But we always used to stick up for the Indians in Britain on the movies, you know?
I heard that in one movie they were making in which they did the Custer Battle, which has never been done well on the screen, but anyway... they used the crows as the ones who attacked Custer.
Yeah.
Whereas actually the crows were the scouts for Custer.
Oh, I see.
And the Sioux, who were working on the picture, were furious and said, if it hadn't been for us, there wouldn't have been any Custer battle.
Well, it's like Nixon having a Japanese watch, isn't it?
Having a what?
Japanese watch, you know.
Does he have a Japanese watch?
He does, yeah, with a Spyro Agnew watch. He has Japanese.
I didn't realize
but
that.
But what's happening with the Indians? I mean, what are they doing for them, you know? Don't they legally really own the land?
Not enough. Interestingly enough, some conservative politicians seem to be more concerned for the Indians than some liberal politicians.
Maybe they've realized how many there are on the whole American continent, including the South.
How many
people think there's only a few Indians left? There's millions of them in the whole continent of America, which includes South America. And one day they're going to be asking for their rights.
Revolution, well, you know, we all want to change the world. You tell me that it's evolution, well, you know, we all want to change the world. But when you talk about destruction, don't you know that you can count me out?
Don't you know it's gonna be
alright? Alright. Alright. You say you got a real solution. Plan. You ask me for a contribution. Well, you know, we all doing what we can. But if you want money for people with minds that hate, all I can tell you is, brother, you have to wait.
Don't you know it's gonna be?
All right.
in the USSR.